Good morning friends. Today I will teach the cultivation practice of gladiolus. Gladiolus belong to the family Iridaceae. The name gladiolus was originated from the Latin word gladiolus, gladioli, meaning a sword, on account of sword-like shape of the foliage. The common name of gladiolus is sword lily because of its sword-shaped foliage. Gladiolus is popularly known as greens of bulbous ornamental plants and is native to Mediterranean region and tropical South Asia. Gladiolus are grown in all parts of the world. In temperate countries, the most important period is summer. In tropical and subtropical climate, it is grown in the winter and spring. Then important and uses of the gladiolus. Gladiolus is very popular flowering plant in international cut flower trades. Its magnificent inflorescence with a variety of colors has made it attractive for use in herbaceous border, beddings, pots, and for cut flowers. For cut flowers, primulinus type are better as more spikes often come out from a corm and they may be planted in isolated borders. Grandiflorus and primulinus type look very attractive in mixed flower border, but primulinus type are preferred as these do not need stacking and so are also good for bedding. Then types and classification of the gladiolus. Total 23 species has so far been used in development of the modern gladiolus cultivars. Classification. First is your grandiflorus or large flower hybrids. These are large or exhibition type gladioli. The plants are vigorous, bearing long spikes with large flowers. Florets are 10 to 20 cm wide, arranged closely and systematically on 90 to 150 cm spikes. Second is your primulinus hybrids. They are also vigorous. The stem grow up to a height of 70 to 105 cm, flowers 5 to 10 cm across, and are well shaped on 40 to 45 cm long spikes. The uppermost inner petals are attractive. Anther and stigma appear above the petal. Then next is your butterfly hybrid. The petals grow a height of 75 to 120 cm. Spikes are shorter than 45 cm. The florets are 7.5 to 10 cm across, having some marking or blotches on the petals. Florets are arranged systematically and closely of the spikes. Next is your miniature hybrids. These hybrids are relatively recent origin. The plant height varies from 75 to 105 cm. The florets are 2.5 to 5 cm across, borne on above 40 cm spike. Many of these hybrids have refilled sepals. They produce very small corm and multiply very slowly. Next is your face up. The stem is dwarf, usually 60 to 90 cm tall. Florets are nearly 5 to 6 cm wide and face upward. Colvilli hybrids. The plant grow hardly more than 60 cm tall. Flowers are 5 to 7 cm across and star shape. These are early flowering hybrids and are more suitable for growing under greenhouse. Next is your orchid Ella hybrids. The new growth of hybrid gladiolus is dump in the Israel. These spikes are light in weight with smaller florets on shorter stem. Then double gladiolus. Normal gladiolus floret consists of 6 tepals. Any gladiolus more than 6 tepals are known as double gladiolus. Then dragons. These group have long twisted tepals with attractive color. Then fragrance. Some South African species of gladiolus have fragrance, and the quality of fragrance varies from apple bloom to rose smell. The first scented gladiolus variety was named as Lucky Star. The varieties. The most promising variety of gladiolus are American Beauty, which is red color, Friendship, pink color, Novalax, yellow color, Peter Pears, orange color, Priscilla, white and light pink color, Spice and Span, orange color, Oscar, red color, White Prosperity, white color, Her Majesty, purple color, Red Candyman, Rani color, Dhanavanti, purple color, Sunny Boy, purple color. Then propagation. Commercially, gladiolus is vegetatively propagated through corm and cormals. For cut flower production, gladiolus is propagated by corms. However, for generation of the planting material, it is propagated by cormals. Gladiolus is propagated by a corm of at least 4 to 5 cm diameter. It should be healthy and disease free. Conical shaped corm is preferred over the flat one, as it gives better flowers. Then soil. Gladiolus can be grown on wide range of soil, from light sandy to clay loams, but deep, well drained, friable, rich in organic matter and nutrients are preferable. For best result, they require a slightly acidic soil of pH 5.5 to 6.5, where most of the nutrients become available to the plant. Then climate. For successful cultivation of this crop, mild climate is ideal, while very hot and too cold atmospheric conditions are harmful. The day temperature should range between 15 to 20 degrees centigrade. Temperature below 6 degrees centigrade may cause the frost injury to the plant. At the time of planting, the soil temperature should not be less than 10 degrees centigrade. Then time of planting and spacing. Under North Indian condition, the gladiolus is planted in the month of October-November. For flower production and for any corm size, spacing of 30 to 45 cm from row to row and 15 to 20 cm corm to corm is maintained, which is depend on the soil condition, size of the corm, and the spacing may be vary. The corm should not be planted too deep or too shallow. The depth of planting should be 2 to 5 cm from the ground level. Corms are to be planted in staggered manner at an interval of 7 to 15 days to get continuous flower for a long period. Then nutrient requirement. 5 kg of FIM per square meter should be incorporated at the time of land preparation. NPK at 1:2:2 should be applied 56 gram per square meter. Half of this nitrogen in the entire dose and the entire dose of phosphorus and potash should be applied at the time of land preparation. The remaining half of nitrogen should be applied 30 to 35 days after planting, because at that stage the plant used to produce the spike. Then interculture operation. First is irrigation. The frequency of irrigation depends largely on the type of the soil and prevailing weather conditions. During warm weather, watering should be done twice a week sufficiently to meet the roots. A gladiolus crop must not be allowed to suffer from water stress, especially when spikes are emerging. regular irrigation at the interval of 7 to 10 days depending upon the weather is necessary. Overwatering should be avoided. Then mulching. Mulching is important for conserving the moisture and reducing the weed population. Its effectiveness is depend on the type of the material and thickness of the mulch used. Mulching is done between and across the rows. Care should be taken to mulch the bed only when there is sufficient moisture, otherwise it will not serve any purpose. Fresh manure, chopped straw, dry grasses, clippings, sawdust, peat, husk, bark, strips of the black polythene may effectively be used as mulch material. Then earthing up. Usually gladiolus corm need 12 to 15 days for sprouting. Initially few days the corm should not be disturbed except the removal of the initial weeds. Once the plant attained a height of about 15 to 20 cm, a light earthing up should be provided from both sides of the row. At this stage, if the weather is dry, amount of water to be applied. Occasionally, the weed should be removed and the soil should be loosened with the help of a fork. When the plant will be 5 to 6 leaf stage, the second earthing up should be done. Then stacking. At 5 to 6 leaf stage, the plant should be stacked with the help of bamboo stick. During stacking, care should be taken to avoid any damage to the underground corm and cormals. Then harvesting. Harvesting of flower spikes. For local market, gladiolus is harvested when the lowermost pair of the floret is fully open. For distant market, harvesting is usually done when the lowermost pair of the floret has just showed the color. For local market, harvesting is usually done in morning hours. Immediately after harvesting, the spikes should be kept in bucket of a plain water. For local market, it is advisable to send the flower in the bucket of water itself. Harvesting for distant market, these are packed gently in some suitable cardboard boxes, wrapping with the loose paper. It is advisable to provide some cotton balls soaked in water at the base of the spike. Then yield of flowers. The flower spike yield in gladiolus is vary according to the cultivar, corm size, planting density and management practices, etc. Approximate yield of flower spike would be around 2 lakhs per hectare. Then grading. Fancy type has spike length. In case of fancy type, spike length is more than 107 cm, and number of florets is 16. For special grade, the spike length is 96 to 107 cm and number of floret is 15. For standard grade, 81 to 96 cm is spike length and number of floret is 12. For utility, spike length is less than 81 cm and number of floret is 10. Harvesting of corm and cormals. Generally, corm and cormal require 30 to 35 more days after harvest to get properly matured. After harvesting of the spikes, water should be withheld and allow the plants to remain in the field itself. When the lower leaves start turning yellow, the corm should be harvested. With the help of a hoe, the entire plant along with corm and cormals should be turned upside down. Then with the help of cicatia, the plant should be detached from the corm and these materials are dried under shed. After that, they are completely cleaned, graded at the size and packed in marketing bag after mixed with bevestine powder. Yield of corm and cormals. The yield of gladiolus corm and cormals is influenced by the cultivar, corm size and other factors. approximately 41.3 tons per hectare corn and cornmeal can be obtained. Then storage of corn. Proper storage of corn and cornmeals are very important, as otherwise storage rot of corn may be occur, rotting of corn may be occur due to fungal infection. Corns are stored in single layer in wooden trays having a wire bottom. The scales over the corns are not removed during the storage. Before storage, corn and cornmeal should be treated with fungicides, then air dried and stored. For gladiolus, 4 to 10 cm cold temperature are required. Then disease and pest management. Disease, first is your fungal fusarium rot and yellow, commonly known as vascular disease, dry rot and core rot, is caused by fusarium species. Roots may show discrete brown lesions or a general rotting. Leaf infection is basal and associated with corm rot, leaf yellowing starting with oldest leaf. Control measure: treat the corm by dipping in carbendazim 1 gram per liter or Keptan 2 gram per liter for 60 minutes after harvesting and before storage. Use the disease free corm stalk. Then gray mold on leaves, large oval to round brown spots appears. Spot occur on the flower and stem also. At first the spots are pale brown and then become dark. A soft brown rotting at the base of floret may develop after rainfall. In a moist cool atmosphere, the whole flower become covered with brownish gray growth of the fungal spore. Control measure: remove old flower spikes and destroy. Hot water treatment at 52 degrees centigrade of corn with carbendazim 1 gram per liter added to the water is very effective in eradicating the pathogen from the planting stock. Then pest, thrips. Thrips are a small insect and are normally not visible in naked eyes. They feed on the leaves, spikes and the florets. Silver and brown sticks are noticed on the affected leaves. These insects can be controlled with melatonin 0.1% spray. Then aphids. Aphids suck the sap from the tender leaves and emerging spikes as well as florets. This can be controlled by spraying with monocotophos at 0.05% can effectively control. Mites. Mites also present in the soil and attack the corn. They occur in the hot season and damage the leaves and buds, which give a pale appearance. Mites can be controlled by application of kerathen 0.5%. Then caterpillar and cutworm. These are occasionally feed on the foliage at spikes. Manual collection and destruction in early stage can check the infestation. Thank you. So this is all about the cultivation of the gladiolus.